This video covers the general balance equation, and it applies for any conserved quantity, mass, energy, momentum, etc. And the way we write it is that the input plus the generation minus the output minus the consumption equals any accumulation in the system. In material and energy balances, we start off by using this in the mass or material balances. So let's take just a simple process here. We have our input, which goes into the system, our output, which comes out of the system, and inside is where we get our generation, our consumption, and our accumulation. So there are some simplifications that we can make. So for example, if the system is steady state, then our accumulation equals zero. If it's steady state and non-reactive, then we have that input equals output. Why don't we look at an example? So we have water that enters a tank at some mass flow rate that we'll call m dot. It exits the tank at a flow rate that equals 2 times m dot. Our tank is initially half full, and we want to know what is the general balance for this process. So we know that we have water that's entering, so we know we have input. We know that we have water that's exiting, so we now know that we have an output. But because it's exiting at a rate twice of what it's going in, we're going to end up with a consumption term, and this is going to equal zero. So this is not at steady state, because eventually the tank is going to empty. Another way that you could look at it is, instead of having a consumption term, you could write it as input minus output equals accumulation, where the accumulation is actually negative. But physically, it makes more sense to use the consumption term.